Video 1.2, Mental Training of a High Degree. In 1956, MGM released Forbidden Planet, a science fiction movie about the lost civilization of the Krell. Here's the opening credits. You'll see a spaceship sent out to look for a lost spaceship. When they reach the Forbidden Planet, they find only two survivors, a scientist, the man in brown, and his daughter, Altera.
Yes, what is this device over here?
I call it their plastic educator. As far as I can make out, they used it to condition and test their young. In much the same way as we once employed finger painting among our kindergarten children. I often play with it myself for relaxation. Although working here, I sometimes wish I'd been blessed with multiple arms and legs. Now then, for the primary function. Actually, to operate, well, I'll choose a familiar subject to start with to save time. There now, gentlemen.
What's that? What's happening there? That's Altera.
Simply a three-dimensional image, Commander.
But it's alive.
Because my daughter is alive in my brain from microsecond to microsecond, while I manipulate. There.
The Krell could think objects into being, actual objects. The scientist could only come up with images, like the image of his daughter. Conservatory boys had similar powers with relation to counterpoint, or multiple musical voices. They could will them into being in their minds with all the interactions of the various voices. It seemed like magic, but it was a result of training. Here, for example, are two versions of a basic schema that was taught to all the boys. The basic version at the top says, leaps of a fifth to above, or fourth down, with thirds and fifths, dum bum bum, on each new note. Below, you see an elaborated version. In Italian, it says, the same rule, but with dissonances. So a more complicated version of the same schema. One of the boys trained in Naples was the composer Traetta from 1767, his Stabat Mater. The circles over certain notes were meant to show how Traetta was going through the schema at a certain pace. The details, of course, differ from the schema, but that's because they were details of his particular instantiation of the underlying schema. It's something he had learned as a little boy, and he could just imagine it into being in music. This was a skill shared by composers all over Europe. Here's a written-out version of the same schema with the upper parts notated. It comes very close to a phrase that Mozart used in the slow movement of his great G minor symphony. Mozart may have had the ability to imagine music in his mind to a greater degree than many other composers, but they also had the same ability. In Naples, they were trained this way. In other places, certain composers may have learned it from direct exposure to lots of similar phrases. In any case, it may seem like magic to us, but it was the result of a high degree of mental training.